Praise the Lord, everybody. This is Pastor Dale. I know it's, of course, you don't know what time I'm doing this at, but it's getting late Sunday evening. Tomorrow's Labor Day, so I guess we can all afford to stay awake a little bit tonight. I decided to do this video because of something that happened today. Something that I had never experienced before, and if I get through this without crying, it'll be a miracle. In the past couple weeks, I've felt as though I haven't been in fellowship with God the way that I usually have done in the past and have been used to. I was out of my element, I guess you would say. And I wasn't living a sinful lifestyle, nothing like that, but I just wasn't doing what I feel that God wanted me to do, and I was looking more to the world for answers than I was Him. And I just didn't feel a closeness to God. Even in my prayer times, I sensed that something wasn't right. And I knew it was me. It wasn't God, that's for sure. It was me. And so I went to service this morning at New Design Church up in Frederick. Pastor Brian, wonderful man of God, and really spoke to my heart during his message this morning. And then he offered up communion. Now, ordinarily, I never, ever, ever miss communion. But as I sat there and he was talking about communion, and I felt, you know, God, I've been on a fellowship, and I don't really think that I should partake in communion. That was at that point. But the more he got into the message, and then all of a sudden I see people around me had their communion elements, you know, in the little container, you know, with the element for the bread and the element of the juice, all in, you know the ones. Anyways, and then I noticed there was other people who didn't have them, and they raised their hand, and the ushers brought them around, and all of a sudden my hand just popped up, and it was at that point that something unique happened to me that I have never experienced before. When I saw the people get the communion cups, when I saw Pastor Brian open up his, and I didn't have one, I suddenly felt so separated from God and so empty inside. It's just like somebody had reached down inside and I was nothing but an empty shell, that all of this was gone. I was an empty shell. That's what it felt like. And it upset my stomach. I mean, I got sick to my stomach. And it's something that I had never experienced before. And so when the usher brought over the elements cup to me, I grabbed it. And when I opened it up, I didn't just take out the cracker. I grasped it. I mean, I grasped it like this. And I thought to myself, I never, ever, ever want to be 1 second of my life without Jesus Christ. Not 1 second. And of course, we partook in the elements and we finished communion. And tears are just flowing down me. I mean, the more I think about it, I can't help but shed tears, because Jesus means that much to me. That it's the most horrible feeling in the world to be without Him and not to have Him part of your life. And that's the way I felt, all because I was out of fellowship. And I went to God and I confessed my sins, and I wanted to come. I told God, I want to come home. I want to come home now. And, you know, in the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, it says it's a fearful thing to fall It's a terrible thing to fall into the hands of the living God. But here's what I got out of this. It is the most wonderful thing in the world to run to the hands of the Father, because He stands there waiting for us. I don't know whether you're a Christian, you watch this, or if you're a non-Christian. If you're a non-Christian, please hear me. Please. Jesus Christ is waiting for you. The Father stands there with open arms, waiting to receive you. He doesn't want you falling into the hands of the living God, which is you don't want. But God wants you to run to Him. Because just like the prodigal son, He stands there like the Father waiting for you. And when you go to Him, He will embrace you. He will hold on to you like you never, never, never have been held in your life. I experienced that again this morning. I literally, when I took that communion and I grasped it and then I partook of it, I felt God's arms around me. I felt His love. And I shared it with my best friend later. And he just stood there and said, "Wow, that's quite an ordeal." And it was. And I pray that if any of you are not right with the Lord Jesus Christ, even if you're a Christian, you're out of fellowship like I was, listen. Go to the Father, because the Bible says if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us of all unrighteousness. And if you haven't asked Jesus Christ into your heart to be your Lord and Savior, please just go to Him and say, "Father, I have sinned. I have been a sinner. And I'm asking You to forgive me. And I'm asking Jesus Christ to come into my heart to be my Lord and my Savior." And at that particular moment, you may not experience anything unique. You may not see stars and busting all around and things like that. But believe this, that you are saved. And I can show it to you in the Bible. And I can guarantee you that you're saved. This is Pastor Dale. I hope you got something out of this. God bless you. I love you all. Bye. Jesus.